today.
Thank you.
and they were known without question. We would pray that all united one day be restored.
Amen.
Great message.
And in heaven it will be.
Great message in that song.
Yes, sir.
Great message.
Yes, sir.
If you think about it, though, that will resurface Marin. So say.
So when you get out that box of tomatoes, you remember this song.
I guess I won't do this with no tomatoes at you. I know you had a bad joke.
Maybe you have to got a story to tell.
You do?
Yeah, but it's not preaching.
Okay.
You all know that I ordered a new building.
Yes.
Some time ago. Well, they brought it a couple weeks ago. One young man, not as big as I am, not as tall as I was, put the building where I wanted. But he came into the house to get the final payment on the building. And he recognized that we were Christians.
Was it by your love?
He saw our Bible and our scripture on the table, the little table we had. And I was impressed. I asked him. He had been an Amish person, raised Amish, but he was Christian. 21 years old. Very good. That's part of the story. The other day, we had a plumbing problem. Well, we called a plumber. I got the book out. I called two or three. Well, I finally found somebody that would come. The man came, was 6'4". He was a young boy. I wondered if he could fix anything. He was a Christian. Before he left, we knew he was a Christian. God is so good.
Amen.
And the fact that we had two people come to our house that we did not tell them we were Christians, and they did not tell us they were Christians, but we knew that they were. I think God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
But I was really impressed with both of them. Both young men living for the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Thanks for reminding us, Chuck. I'll try to be on my best behavior.
I got it.
Thank you for your vote of confidence.
337.
337. Yes, sir. special prayer requests that I need to be made aware of? I would just ask, being heard from my little nephew Wyatt off of church camp, it's the first time he's ever been away from his mom.
We never called Dorothy today.
Oh, okay.
She's not here. I don't know.
I think that they were going somewhere. Family or...
I
they went to D.C.
They went to a birthday party.
Birthday party, that's what
DC,
I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they're all fine.
I started to say, Wyatt's never been away from his mom overnight, so I pray that he doesn't get, you know, homesick. Because you know where the church camp is? Did I tell you?
Ripley.
Yeah, it's down Ripley, believe it or not.
Okay.
So, it will be quite a trip for my sister. I have to run down there and pick him up. But I pray that he's going to... He'll be 12 July 31st. And so I just pray that he's going to have a good experience. And, I don't know really any other critical prayer requests. I was just kind of curious if y'all were aware of any. Try to keep me in the loop.
My friend Abdal have cancer. Andrew Vega, his brother is Scott Vega. His dog have cancer and he have 3 weeks to live.
Okay, what's your friend's name, Andrew?
Andrew Vega. And his brother have the dog have cancer.
Okay.
It's Scott Vega.
April said this morning, I think she's here, that her sister has an infection. You might ask her.
Angel have an infection?
Her and Robbie have both have an infection. It's pretty bad.
Hmm. Did they like go swimming in the same pool?
I think they went, I'm assuming it's when they went to Tappan Lake, maybe. I don't know, but it looks pretty bad.
Well, you saying they both had it at the same time, that's why I thought. Were they in the same body of water that they picked up the same...
They were in a lake a couple weeks ago, so... Yeah.
They may need to get that checked out.
Yeah. She went to the ER to give her meds, but the way it looks, I told her, I was like, you can probably go to the ER again, but if it's... They're probably going to want you to take your antibiotic before they do anything like surgery or anything, so...
Well, yeah, but they would draw a culture with both of them getting at the same time to figure out what it is that they're up against.
Yeah.
So.
Somebody said Harry Williams.
Harry Williams?
Yeah.
Okay. Didn't we have him on our list here a couple weeks ago?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, boss.
All right. Any others?
Betty.
Yeah, she's in about third way down first column.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's pray. Father, it's good to be here tonight, and it's nice that Pastor Brian Fish is here to fill in for me. I pray your blessing upon him. And just pray, Father, that you'll continue to bless and use him. And pray, Father, that you will help churches. Churches everywhere need help. Father, it's your people. It's not the buildings. But, Father, there just really seems to be a dryness. And I know, Father, the problem is not with you. The problem is with us. We really do need you to work in our hearts to revive us, to inspire us. Father, it's very discouraging to see the way that the world around us seems to be going the wrong direction. And pray, Father, that you might help us to hold fast, to continue on the path that we know that we should be on. I can't help but think many times as we continue to see the cultural decay around us, that your son told us that before he comes again, things are going to get really bad. If it weren't for the fact that you were gracious, Father, I'm afraid that we would just abandon you altogether. So pray that you might stir our hearts to understand that we really do need you. We do pray, Father, for these needs that we've talked about, physical needs. Of course, course, I've been speaking about the spiritual needs, but there are physical needs that people are in desperate need of you doing something for. And we just join together at this time and pray, Father, that you might meet those needs. We are concerned about Betty. This problem with her back that probably started over a month ago does not seem to be getting any better. We pray that something can be done to relieve her pain so that she can get back here and join us. Father, we pray for Angel and Robbie that have this ear infection, and Father, that it's not anything more serious. Please take care of them and help them to get better. We pray for Harry Williams, who's battling cancer, that, Lord, you would meet Harry's needs. Please, Father, help him during this time to know that you're there with him. And again, we pray that this cancer could be overcome and it could be returned out this strength. Grateful that Hank could be here this morning. We just pray that something could be done to get rid of the fluid. We pray, too, for Sheila Tassi, that, Lord, you would help her over cancer. We pray, Father, for this special prayer request that Turtle had for his friend Andrew. They've got a dog that's not well. Trust, Lord, that you'll even take care of these, because we know that you care about even those things within our lives. But, Father, there are just a lot of names and needs that are listed in the bulletin that I'm not going to take time to go over, except to say, Father, we put those names there because these people need your help. And we just ask for your continued blessings. I do pray for Wyatt, as he's at church camp this week, that he's going to have a great week helping with any feelings of homesickness, that he might sense your nearness and know that all is well. But thank you for being our God, and thank you for this time together tonight. And just pray, Father, your blessing upon it. Again, Father, help our leaders of our country to make decisions that are honoring you. We pray, too, for our military and law enforcement, that you might keep them safe. And we do pray, Father, that you might revive us as your people. Thank you for being our God. We love you. Continue to ask your blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.